Hey there, what is going on? So have you ever wished that you could know how big your widget would be, no matter what the device, no matter whatever? If so, then the Layout Builder is definitely what you're looking for. Basically, the Layout Builder is used to figure out the size of its parent widget. In this case, it's the center, which pretty much takes up the whole screen. And thanks to this, you'll be able to know exactly what the maximum width and the maximum height will be for you to place your widgets. So if you want to learn how to use this, you're in the right video. Here we are, and the UI is super simple. I'm gonna hit this and this, and it's basically just a row, which is this whole thing. And then this right here is the column, and box three is just this container right here. As you can see, the column just has two containers as well, and they are very similar. So right now, if we just turn this around, this is what happens, which, you know, is not responsive at all. And not being responsive is the trait of terrible apps. So that's not gonna be our app. First thing is this little space right here on the right. It's kind of annoying me. And sure, you could do something like this and hit the save button and now it looks good, but that will only work for this specific device. And if your app only looks good on one specific device, good luck with that. So let's go back to this. And this is exactly where the Layout Builder can be quite handy. In this case, we're going to wrap the row because we want to find out the size of the center widget. Because the center widget is essentially taking up the whole space of the screen. So that makes it the perfect parent for the Layout Builder. But if you just wanted to know the size of box 1, for example, then you would make the Layout Builder the child of box 1. And instead of child, I'm going to use the builder property. And obviously, it doesn't take a widget. It actually takes a function. And that function has two arguments, which is the context and, more importantly, the constraints. And then we just return the widget like this, and boom. So just to reiterate, if you press Ctrl Q on the builder, you will see that it's a function and it takes a build context and box constraints, which we call context and constraints. Now that we have access to constraints, we can just go ahead and copy this. And the first thing we're going to do is fix this white space right here. So instead of width 200, we're going to go ahead and do constraints.maxWidth. As you can see, there's also min width and min height, but that's usually zero. Max width and max height are what will help you the most. But you don't just go constraints.maxWidth. No, you, for example, in this case, we want box 1 to occupy 50% of the size from here to here. And remember, the row takes up as much space horizontally as it can. So the row right now is taking up this space all the way to this space. And that's what the row does. It always takes up as much space horizontally as it possibly can. Just like the column will always take up as much space vertically as it can. And this column specifically goes from here to here because it's wrapped within a row. But it's still taking up as much space vertically as it can. So now that you know this, I'm just going to do constraints.maxWidth times 0.5 because that's 50%. And I'm going to do exactly the same thing for box 2 as well as box 3 because we want all of them to occupy 50% of the row space. So I'm hit save. And now, as you can see, the whole screen is filled up. And even if you change the device, the same thing will happen. However, even like this, if you do this now, once you turn it around, the boxes get way too tall. Because we don't want these boxes to occupy the whole screen just because you turn it around. So to fix that, let's just go ahead and use the max height option. So instead of height like this, I'm going to do this. And, you know, basically you just have to experiment. I'm just going to do this. I think it will work. And now that these two are both 24% of the height, well, right now they're width because I actually forgot to change this. But now that they're both 24% of the height, I'm going to go ahead and take this. And over here, I'm going to do the double of that. So instead of 24, I'm going to do 48. And I'm going to hit save and let's see if the sizes match. Okay, that's pretty close. I will take it. But and now that it's like this, if I turn it around, now this also adapts to the screen once it turns around. It's taking up 48% of the screen, and you know, 24 plus 24, which is also 48. So this is a really quality way to make sure your apps are responsive. And many argue that this is a much better solution to media queries. And sometimes it can be, because as you could see, it was very easy to implement. You just use the Layout Builder, you just give it its own context, and you use the constraints to figure out the sizes of everything. Something else we can do is, for example, if constraints.maxWidth are less than 450, And by the way, I know that this specific device has a width of about 400 and something, like 405 or 6, something like that. So basically, if it's over 450, it will be in landscape in this case. So if this is true, I want it to be times 0.24. Just to show you the difference, really. It doesn't really matter. And if it's like this, it's going to be like this. So I'm going to hit the save button. And as you can see, it's already like this. And if I turn it around, then it looks good. I just realized I actually did it the other way around. I meant like this. But you got the point. Like, if I hit save, this is what it looks like. And then if I turn it around, it just changes up like this. So as you can see, it's very easy to implement different circumstances. And because you're using a builder, that's why it's called a layout builder, it will update automatically, making it all work very well. So this is just another option to make your apps more responsive. And as you just saw, it was very easy to implement. Just put in the widget, give it a builder property, and make up the function that does exactly what you want. So I want to keep this video short because, in my opinion, the layout builder is not very hard to understand. And it's very useful. Sometimes you will still need to use the media query for when you want the information to be here, for example. It's really up to you. Just work with the knowledge you've got and you'll eventually figure out what works best for you. If you don't know how to use media queries, then you can just click the video on the top right, and I'll also leave it in the suggestions at the end of this video. But I hope this video helped you out in any way. If it did, please leave me a like and hit that subscribe button to keep on learning more and more about Flutter. That will be it for today. Thank you so much for watching. This is Flutter Mentor, and out.